Today's topic is engine compression and combustion speed, and I want to put firm in your mind the relationship between the two. As you increase the compression in the upper cylinder at top dead center, you increase the speed at which the fuel-air mixture is burned. As the rings wear down, that compression lowers, and it lowers that speed. And I'm going to show you how that relates to engine power. If you look at this chart right here, you can see that we have the combustion pressure. This line right here is top dead center. Its peak pressure is happening at 10 degrees after top dead center. Right here we have the force that this puts on the crank, because right here, even though the pressure is the highest right here, it's at a very poor angle between the conrod and the crank wheels. So as you get more over here, you have a better relationship between those two with a better angle. The best angle being 90 degrees, of course. So this right here is the crank force. What happens when you have lowered compression? You lower from this green graph to this blue graph. You have a lower peak here, even though at later degrees of crank rotation, you actually have a little bit better PSI. And how that affects the force on the crank is it makes it happen a little bit later, and the overall sum of all this is going to be less. So the easiest thing to change when you have any need for tuning the engine, of course, is the jetting. The thing is, though, there's a relationship between the jetting and the combustion speed. The best combustion speed is with ideal jetting. If you go leaner than that or richer than that, you have slower combustion speed. So right here it says leaner or richer from ideal decreases the combustion speed. So when you lose compression and that combustion speed slows down and you want to speed it back up, you can't do it with jetting. You would have to use a thinner head gasket or increase the squish velocity. As you increase the squish velocity, what happens out here, the swirl that happens due to the squish velocity, you increase the combustion speed, which is the only way to combat this, even though you're not going to get back up to the original power. You could also shift the timing a little bit more advanced, move this all a little bit to the left, that helps a little bit. As you move this to the left, this will raise up more right here. But like I said, even doing that, you're not going to get the original power. If you're going to increase the squish velocity, that's easy to do. But it's nice to have a squish velocity calculator that tells you what your squish velocity is at the moment. And by changing the amount of clearance between the head and the piston, then it will tell you what the increase of the velocity will be. This one that I sell also gives a recommendation for the squish volume, the amount of fuel air that's underneath the squish area, the squish band, and gives you a detonation risk, and also tells you, gives you an idea of how you can also change engine oil. Yeah, this is a new thing, engine oil. I almost forgot about it. It's so new, even I forget about it sometimes. You can change the combustion speed with engine oil. I know you get a nice clean engine. You don't have to take it apart to clean out the carbon very often. That synthetic is so sweet. But it's a slow burn oil. I know a lot of people think that caster cruds up the engine. I'm telling you, if you got the jetting and the timing right, it's just a little bit more. Okay? Caster's fine. Caster's great. It'll give you the best power. And look, I'm not even plugging a certain company. No one's paying me to say this. This is really what I believe. Check out my video on castor oil and increasing engine power by using it. And so, yeah, I guess that's it. Just a short little video talking about engine compression and combustion speed. Thanks for watching.